This video was created by librarians at Southern Utah University. It is the second in a series on synthesizing information. This video discusses how to create a synthesis matrix. A synthesis matrix is a grid that helps you organize ideas from your research. It aids you in making connections and in identifying the scholarly conversation. The matrix puts each source you want to use in the columns. In the header row, at the top of each column, you put the citation of your source. Since space is limited, we recommend using the in-text citation style. Each row represents a main idea that you can discuss in your paper or presentation. Each main idea is placed in column one. What you call the main idea is up to you, but short descriptive names are best. But the matrix is just for your own use, so you can call it whatever you like. The cells of the matrix are filled with summaries, in your own words, of how the idea is used in the source. For example, a description of the positive reinforcement idea from China, Mills, and Cooper, 2020, goes in the intersecting cells, more effective than other training methods, page 1, page 9. The page numbers are included so that you can easily find it again. Some citation styles require page numbers, so it's always handy to have the page number if that is the case. Note that not all sources will cover all the main ideas, so some of the cells will be empty. The process is as follows. Starting with your first source, put the in-text citation at the top. Then start reading, listening, or watching that source. Whenever you come across an idea, add it to a new row by listing it in the leftmost cell. In the intersecting cell, write a brief description and add the page number. It's important to write the description in your own words because simply copying what the source said could lead you to accidentally plagiarizing your source. So do some of that difficult writing here. Once you pull out all the applicable ideas from the first source, go to the next one and repeat the process. The only difference will be that some ideas that you come across will already have a row, so you can add to the existing row. For new ideas, you'll add a new row. Creating a synthesis matrix requires you to engage with your source to capture the ideas from the scholarly conversation. This requires time and effort, so it is important to plan for this and not start at the last minute. While your instructor might allow different source types, creating a matrix mainly requires you to closely read scholarly articles that can sometimes be heavy and technical. Understanding how scholarly sources work can save you time and effort. This diagram shows the common components of scholarly articles: title, author, abstract, introduction or literature review, methodology, research results, discussion, conclusion, and references. These components are often labeled with section headings, but not always. When reading, especially for synthesis, you should start with the abstract, introduction, and conclusion, looking for the content and main points the authors want you to learn. These are good places to start looking for the main ideas that you might want to talk about in your paper. The literature review summarizes the conversation on the paper's topic up to the point of the article's publication. This section is great for finding additional sources for your paper. The methods and results may be very technical, since they are describing how the study was conducted and will list the results of the study. These sections are useful for checking the accuracy of the article, but aren't always helpful for your purposes. The discussion will have the details that explain the results and will most likely be where you find the information you can actually cite. Look for more details in the discussion section about the main points you found in the introduction and conclusion. They usually appear in the same order they are listed in the introduction and conclusion. As you read and identify ideas, begin noting them in your matrix. Now let's make our own matrix together using four short sample sources. The topic of our research is education for students with disabilities. We start with a blank matrix, which shows where the sources and main ideas will go. We're going to fill this out source by source. Let's begin with source one. What are the interesting ideas to use from this source? What are some of the main points of this source? As we read through, we see inclusion, and also alternative settings. We can then add those ideas to the main ideas column. Then in the cell where the column for the first source and the idea intersect, we can add more details about how the source talks about the idea. You can do this for the two ideas we have pulled out for this example. It is possible that you have other ideas that you want to use. Identify what you think is interesting. As we can see here in our updated matrix, we have the two main ideas and then brief summaries of how Source 1 covers them. After processing your first source, you move on to Source 2. What are some of the interesting ideas in this source? Do you see any of the ideas we have already added to our matrix? Do you see any new ideas that require a new row? Full inclusion can be added to the existing inclusion row. And then we can add the idea of having specialist educators in a new row, which will look like this on the matrix. As you can see, we added to the first line how Source 2 talks about inclusion, and then added educators as a main idea and how Source 2 talks about it. Since Source 1 didn't talk about educators, we will leave that cell blank, just as we did for Source 2 talking about alternative placement. In Source 3, the main idea is also about inclusion, so we can add it to the existing idea row. Again, there are probably more interesting ideas to pull out here, such as social interaction, but we're going to keep this example simple and short. Source 3 only talks about inclusion, so we can leave the other two ideas cells empty. Source 4 is about alternative placement. We can add a summary to the existing row we already have for this idea. The source also discusses different combinations and methods that are tailored to what each student needs. This method is called differentiation, which is a new main idea, so we can add that to a new row. We now have added all four sources to our example matrix. When you are writing a research paper, you will likely have many more sources, but we are keeping it simple for this example. Looking at our finished matrix, at first glance, we can see that we have enough sources to write a paragraph about inclusion. We have two ideas that each have one source to learn from. This means that we need to do some additional targeted research to find more information on those ideas if we want to include them in our paper. Finally, we have one source that only had a single idea. This may mean that we didn't read it very carefully, as most sources discuss multiple ideas. Perhaps we need to give that source a more careful look. To learn more about how to use the synthesis matrix, please watch the next video, How to Use a Synthesis Matrix.